Okay, so let's start our webinar in English number 9. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Peter Steimer. I am involved in the product development of Cobra here at DataM. Also tubes, mainly databases. And I'm also working with the design services, especially for tubes. Our topic today is just a quick preview on the innovations we will present at the Tube Fair 2012 in Düsseldorf. First, we will have a quick overview over the general functionality of the Cobra automatic tube mill, which means parametric flower design, parametric roll design. Then a few words on cage forming, and then we get to the innovations we will introduce at the Tube in Düsseldorf. So, let's begin with the basics in the Cobra automatic tube mill. We begin with the parametric flower design, which, yeah, we can compare with a receipt from a cookbook. If you follow all of the steps described in a cookbook, you should be able to get a dish out of it. And it may be easy to vary just the amount of the ingredients to get more or less of the dish, but you should be able to get it in the same quality. Compare this to the Cobra automatic tube mill, because we do not define a specific design for a specific product, but we define a forming strategy. This means you can put the company's best practices or the company's experiences into the software, and then use this strategy to just design tool sets for different tube diameters using this one strategy. This gives lots of work, because the tool set and the flower will be created automatically according to the strategy you entered there, and it will also enable you to conserve the strategies in the software, so that the designer not has to think always if he put all the strategies into the design, so the software will take care of this. Let me give you a few examples on which parameters to enter in the Cobra automatic tube mill. So, in this example, we see the very start of a project in Cobra. So, the first step is just to define your stations you have in the tube mill you want to produce the tube at. Here we see we have, in this example, a breakdown pass. And here in this list, we see all of the stations we have in our tube mill. So in this example, a breakdown pass, an idler pass, another breakdown pass followed by an idler pass, then the fin passes, and at the bottom of the list we would find the welding pass and the sizing passes. So this is a praxis-oriented way to enter the data into the tube mill, making it easier for the designers to deal with the abstract possibilities to enter the forming strategy. Okay, the next step would be to define the product's parameters, the tube's parameters, which is, of course, the tube's diameter, the desired welding diameter, and a range of thicknesses to produce this tube, this mill. So we define a nominal thickness and we define a maximum thickness. Further, we will define the strategy itself by a list of additions, which is, for example, the reduction addition, which means the reduction we want to achieve in the fin passes. There is a welding addition, meaning the material lost over the cross section by welding squeeze out. And of course, a sizing addition. This means how much material do we lose in the cross section, in the cross sectional length, in the sizing passes. The next step would be to define the forming steps. And one important thing about this is that we do not have to define bending radii, but we should define the forming steps, the cross sections in the specific stations, just by bending angles. The reason for this is that when we define our strategy by angles, we can reuse this strategy also for different tube diameters. Okay, there is other parameters we will see in the next picture. It's also possible to define defined downhill forming. Okay, so let's go on to the parameters. This is one more interesting thing about the Cobra automatic cube mill. We can define our additions or fin widths for ranges of tube diameters. So in this example, we see from 80 to 90 tube diameter, we have a reduction addition from 1.4 and from a diameter of 90 on to a bigger diameter, we have a reduction addition of 1.3 millimeters. This enables the designer to just use those parameter lists for any diameter you want to produce on this mill. We just have to define this once for a mill and can then rely on that for each different product we want to produce on this mill. Okay, once we defined our general tube parameters and the strategy, the flower will be generated just by the press of a button. So, and the result is, of course, the forming flower with our defined tube diameter, our desired welding diameter, and all of the forming steps with the angles, with the strategy we defined before. The roll design according to this flower is pretty similar. I use just a few examples of the parameter to define here. So, for example, minimum diameters for top, bottom and side rolls, tolerances, minimum gap between roll and profile to be sure the top roll, for example, in the breakdowns will not damage the strip edge by undesired contact there. So the minimum diameters are just to ensure that you have enough material between the bore and the roll's contour, or between the shaft and the strip itself. And the tolerances, of course, are used to get even dimensions at parts of the roll which are not involved in the forming itself. One more important parameter you will know from practice also are the root diameters of the roll. So they are defined in a in a spreadsheet like way, and they are important to, for example, maintain a constant height position of the bottom axis, and by varying the base diameters we can get a downhill forming. Or one other purpose for this is to get an advance in the driven rolls, to get to pull the material through the machine by advancing the diameters of the driven rolls. and quite similar to what we did at the flower, we can create our rows by just pressing the button. Of course, the rows will be created by the flower we defined before and by the parameters we entered for the row layout then. Once we are through this procedure and we have roughly the row set we defined by our parameters, there is the possibility to modify the stations, to modify the rows interactively. This means we have here a view of the rows in the current station, in the current pass, and we can modify the machine data for this pass and the row data for the respective rows interactively. Interactively means we will see the changes we do here immediately also in the Cobra drawing then. And the nice thing about this is that also those interactive row modifications will be taken into our database of role creation strategies. So also those modifications will be taken into account when you create a future project, when you create a future role set with on this mill with those settings. Then just a quick word on cage forming. There is also a cage forming module in Cobra, which allows for defining those cage beams holding the rows by just entering a few parameters in a spreadsheet. So for example, the rows contour, the rows distance inside a beam, and the change of angle from roll to roll. those cage beams can be saved as a independent part and can be used for future projects, for example, with different diameters, by just adjusting the position of the cage beams. The forming cage can also be transferred to Cobra FEA RF for a FEM simulation of the project, and this can also be done automatically by just pressing the button. So let's come to the innovations we will present you at the Cube Fair. So the first thing is a dynamic remesh function for Cobra FEA RF. And those of you making FEM simulations for the projects may know the problem. So what we see here is just a round tube, and this round tube is then used to create a shaped tube out of it. Usually we want to simulate the process from the flat strip to the round tube and then directly to the shaped tube. And the problem with this process at the moment is that for the round tube, to simulate the round tube, we need a rather rough mesh. And for the simulation of the shaped tube with small bending radii, we need a refined mesh. Here we see the bending zones with the refined mesh. And at the moment, we would have to start with the refined mesh also for the simulation of the round tube, which costs much calculation time because of the of the increased element count. And one other problem is that usually the main thing of the mill is the forming of the round tube, and then the forming of the shaped tube will only involve just a few stations. So we have to have those refined parts of the mesh, we have to take it through the whole calculation, although we do not really need it in the first part. The solution for this problem is the dynamic remesh function, which just means we simulate up to the round tube with a rather rough mesh, which is enough for the calculation of the round tube. And then at calculation time, we will refine the mesh in the desired positions to be able to form the shaped cube, in this case, just a rectangular tube. This saves, of course, the calculation time up to the round tube, which is the main part of the mill. And we can be sure that the refinement of the mesh is done in the correct positions, because we do not need to pull the refine strip through all of the mill, but only through the shaped tube part of the mill. So the next point are the tube mill variants. So when you have a look at those pictures, you see what we want to do here is to produce a tube with different wall thicknesses with the same roll set. So we can see here the maximum wall thickness. The top roll has contact over the whole cross section, and in the upper picture we can see the smaller wall thicknesses, which is just formed by adjusting the axis, the shaft positions of the top roll. In Cobra, up to now, there was no way, no comfortable way to do this. Of course, there are workarounds like creating sub-projects with only the breakdown passes for the different wall thicknesses, but yeah, as mentioned, this is not really a comfortable way to do this. In the next version of Cobra introduced at the tube, there will be the possibility to create variants of the tube mill project inside one Cobra project. This means it's possible to create variants for different wall thicknesses or wall thickness ranges. And it's possible to just adjust the top rolls of the breakdown passes to achieve the variant, or it is possible to create a new top roll for different sheet thickness ranges. It's also possible to optionally involve modifications to the parametric in the Cobra automatic tube mill, but not necessarily. So if you already have produced a roll set, you may not want to change the design by eventual changes in the tube mill parametric, but when you create a new one, you will want to involve the parametric changes just for new projects. The next news is the inventor interface. It will now be possible to have a 3D export of roles to Autodesk Inventor. The interface will create parametric three-dimensional roll drawings, and the bore attributes are available as parametric features inside the three-dimensional roll drawing. Further, there is a possibility to create automatic 2D sections of roles in Inventor. It's possible to create dimensioned 2D sections in Inventor, and the nice thing about this functionality is that there are customizable templates for 2D roll drawings. This means the designer is now able to modify the templates used for the dimensioning to, for example, just modify where he wants to have which dimensions in the drawing. We have also the possibility to export the whole tube mill or the whole mill to Inventor, which we can see here. We have an illustration of the profile in here. We have the bearings in here. We can, of course, fade out things like bearings, snap rings, and so on. There is the possibility of collision control, for example, only for one station or for one station and the next stations, just to detect possibly collision of rolls, which may not always be visible in the 2D sectional view of Cobra itself. Further, the rolling direction is adjustable. In this example, at the left bottom of the picture, we have the finished tube. At the top right of the picture, we have the flat strip. We can turn around this to be able to create the stands around the rolls and so on. The next news is the RLM database, which may not be that interesting for tube manufacturers, but more for open profiles and such products. So the idea behind this RLM, this roll lifecycle management database, is to have the whole stock of rolls available in a database, just to enable the designer to quickly search his stock of rolls, to be able to reuse existing rolls in future projects, or maybe to use rolls from old projects for future profiles. And there are functions to manage the stock of rolls. This means to check out defective rolls, to release defective rolls for reworking, and so on. And this picture here just shows us that the design department, the construction department, the production department, and the service department have access to the role lifecycle management system, for example, for production planning. So one example would be, can I produce two profiles parallelly, and do I have enough rows to produce the profile parallelly? Or, for example, there is an interface for the Cobra roll scanner with the possibility to store the measured roll contour into the database, just to see the wear history of the roll over a period of time. So those are the general possibilities of the RLM database. So here again is just the idea behind this database. As mentioned, the stock of rolls, the properties of all of the rolls should be stored to a database, and this enables the designer to search and reuse suitable rolls from stock to use in new projects. On the other hand, if there are rolls which have to be ordered or produced, there is the possibility to create a detailed bill of material, and when those rolls are delivered or produced, they will be booked on stock, and the designer will have the possibility to use them in future projects also. So this was the quick overview over the innovations we will present at the Tube in Düsseldorf. I would like to invite you to be our guest at our booth. booth at the tube in hall 4, stand if19, to have a closer look at the new functionalities or to discuss the new functionality, and of course to hear your wishes or requirements of maybe new functionality in Cobra or and so on. Okay, there will be Bavarian snacks while stocks last, and we would be glad to have you as our guest at the Tube.